I was somewhere around Barstow, on the edge of the desert, when the campaign began to take hold. I was on my way to Las Vegas to cover the main story of our generation, the race for the White House, when I came upon Martin O'Malley.
Get in. This is back country.
O'Malley was once the governor of Maryland, and now he's running for president as a Democrat. His poll numbers were low, but with the presidential debate coming up, he had a chance to break out. And I knew that the idea of trying to cover this race in any conventional press sense was absurd.
You want a beer?
No, I'm good, man.
How about some ether?
No, I'm good on the ether.
Good answer, I thought. There's nothing in the world more helpless and irresponsible and depraved than a presidential candidate in the depths of an ether binge.
So, speaking of drugs, you're president of the United States, and the state wants to legalize marijuana. What do you do as president?
You know, I was just out in Colorado, and I think we should keep an open mind and look at what Colorado's doing and Washington State and learn from it.
Did you ever try it yourself, marijuana?
I never have.
That explained why O'Malley couldn't see the huge bats all swooping and screeching and diving around the car. And that got me wondering, what would Hunter S. Thompson, the man I was poorly impersonating, think of the current presidential race?
He'd probably say that the Democratic Party's hurting itself badly by waiting so long to start our debates.
Are Democrats conspiring against the candidates not named Hillary Clinton?
Yeah, it's hard to say. It would appear to me that they're trying to circle the wagons around this year's inevitable frontrunner. And I think it shows a lot of fear about the future.
O'Malley was about to go head-to-head against Hillary Clinton in Las Vegas. I wanted to ask, what's your strategy? Did I say that out loud?
I'll be the one candidate on that stage that has 15 years of executive experience working on the front lines of some pretty difficult issues.
What do you think is the difference between Bernie Sanders, Democratic Socialist, and a Martin O'Malley Democrat?
I don't believe that banks, the big banks on Wall Street, should be able to run roughshod over the common good of our national economy. And I believe our federal government has a role to play in preventing that. On the other hand, I don't believe the federal government should nationalize our banks. I don't believe that the answer to every question is to create a national monopoly.
Bernie Sanders has called for free universal college education at public universities.
I think there's a problem with just simply having the federal government cut the check to make college tuition free. But I do believe that the goal of debt-free college and making that an option for people is something that's very much overdue.
There's been a lot of talk about pathway to citizenship for people who are here illegally, which you support.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. But a lot of Republicans will say, well, we're not going to give that to you legislatively unless you secure the border.
We have done more by way of securing the border and deportations as a nation than we have in a long, long time. I intend as president to extend executive action to as many people as I possibly can.
A lot of the attention has been on Hillary Clinton and Bernie Sanders, but hasn't necessarily been in your direction, at least to this point. What's going on here?
One of the rules of thumb in these presidential contests is that whatever candidate is surging in September is not the candidate who's surging in January. But I believe this campaign's heading into another phase now.
The presidential race was definitely underway. I had witnessed the start. I was sure of that. But what now? What comes next?